by request, a little explanation of the parts per million and how we convert from percentage to parts per million. First off, why do we use the parts per million scale? Well, it's to make the figures a little bit more manageable. First off, let's have a look. Right, if we have 1 million parts per million, then safe to say that is 100%. A million parts per million is everything which is 100%. Now, if we look at a figure that we use daily, we use at work, 30 parts per million. Let's write that down. 30 parts per million is what we're allowed to be exposed to carbon monoxide in an 8-hour shift. Now, if we were trying to convert that into percentage, we'll do the conversion in a moment, that then comes out at 0.03%. Normal working day, yeah, there's a lot of noughts there, there's a lot to play with. In a mind rescue and high stress situation, you know, 1 0 out, if we were to make that accidentally, just to miss a zero out, that then creates us 30 parts per million of our carbon monoxide. That we're allowed, that's where you're going to start to ruin your day. So that's why we use the parts per million scale, because it's a more tangible, more simple number that we can remember. Just have a look at converting from one to the other. Let's just write that out, yeah. Right. Looks like mathematics. It's not maths. It's very simple, so don't worry about it. I want to write up here, it's what we need to remember. 4 decimal places. To convert percentage to PPM, or PPM to percentage, this is all we need to remember. And I'll show you why. So first off, let's go from PPM to percentage. Let's pick that figure again. 30 PPM. And we want to turn that into percentage, so we're going to move 4 decimal places. At the moment, it's safe to say that there's my decimal place, because it's 30, it's a full round number. I'm just going to put some zeros on the front there. And you see, I put 3 zeros on the front there, it still doesn't change it, because it's still 30. It's just loaded up with zeros on the front. Makes it a bit easier for us. So we're going to move that 4 decimal places now. So there's our decimal place. We're going to move 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that's now where we're resting. There's our new decimal place. That's not PPM anymore. It's now percentage. Converting back the other way, let's choose a relatively small percentage. We're going to go for 0.006%. Now we want to convert that into PPM now. Exactly the same, 4 decimal places, but we're going to go the other way. Count with me. So there we are, so we're going to move 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we needed to add an extra zero in there, and that's our new decimal place. That one's now gone. Get rid of those zeros off the front because we don't need them anymore, because there's our round figure. Now it's not a percentage, it's now parts per million. It's as simple as that. It's not maths, just moving the dot. What we're going to do, now time for you to work it out. Remember, 4 decimal places. So tell me, I've now got 400 parts per million. In your own time, work it out. Press pause now. No, not the camera lady. Camera's still rolling. Anyway, press pause, come on. Right, and you're back in the room. So 400 parts per million. I'm going to do the working out, but let's see how close you got to it. 400 parts per million. So there's our decimal points, it's 400. 400 point. Yeah, we can load the front and the back up with zeros. It's not going to change it, it's still 400. It's where that is, which is important. So we're now going to convert PPM to percentage. four decimal places. One, two, three, and four. So there's our new spot. Let's get rid of that one. And now let's get rid of the zeros that we don't need. So zeros on the end, and that one from there. So now we've gone from that to 0.04%. Hopefully you got that one right. Let's try another one. Other way this time. Percentage, 0.0002. Crikey, a lot of zeros there. Now you can see why we use the ppm scale. Trying to convey that to someone, 0.00, how many noughts? Crikey. That's a percentage. Exactly the same again. Move four decimal places. There's our spot. 1, 2, 3, 4. So our new decimal places there. Get rid of the old one. Get rid of all the zeros in front that we don't need.